Good morning, everyone. We are going to start chapter 12. Title of the chapter is Houses We Live In. It's very hot today. Where will you go? You are feeling cold. Where will you go? You will go to your house. Wind is moving. Where will you go? You will go to your house. Dangerous animal is coming. Where will you go? You will go to your house. Where will you keep your money? You will keep your money in your house. It's raining. Where will you go? You will go to your house. Why? Because house is very important for us. A house is a place where we live in. House provides us shelter. Shelter means a place to live or stay. House protects us from thieves, dangerous wild animals, heat, cold, wind and rain. We feel safe inside our house. So, whenever we feel hot, we feel cold, we go to our houses. It rains, we go to our houses to protect ourselves. We keep our wealth in our houses. Now, all of you have understood that why is house so important for us. There are different types of houses. Block of flats. Flat is a set of rooms for living in, usually on one floor of a large building. There are two types of apartments, low-rise apartment and high-rise apartment. Low-rise apartment has height up to four floors. High-rise apartment has more than four floors. Cottage is mainly found in the villages or in the countryside. A cottage may be built of stone or bricks or of timber. Skyscraper is a tall building having multiple floors. Detached house doesn't share any wall with a separate structure. All of you, look at the pictures of these types of houses. Semi-detached house, you can see here that semi-detached house shares at least one wall with an existing structure. Terraced house, a house in a row of houses that shares a wall with the houses next to it. Farmhouse is a building in a rural or agricultural setting. Villa is a large building. There are mainly two types of house, kaccha house and pakka house. People mainly living in villages built kaccha house. Kaccha house is made of mud, straw, woods. People living in towns and cities built pakka house. Pakka house is made of brick, cement, steel and wood. Pakka house is stronger than kaccha house. Houses can be grouped as temporary and permanent house. Temporary house can be moved from one place to another place. Permanent house can't be moved from one place to another place. We live in permanent house for many years. Such type of house is built on mountains. It has sloping roof. It is made of wood. It has sloping roof because as it rains or snow heavily on mountains, it easier for the rainwater and snow to slide off from such type of sloping roof. Now all of you look at this one. Such type of house is called stilt house. In some areas where it rains, people built stilt house. There is the gap between house and ground. Stilt is the structure that supports house. All of you look at this picture, you see these bamboos. These bamboos are stilt for this house because it provides support to the house. This is a houseboat. Houseboat moves on water from one place to another. House is on the boat. Such type of house you can see in Kerala and Jammu Kashmir. Now look at this one. This house is called caravan. This house move on wheels. This is a temporary house. This is not a permanent house because this house can be moved from one place to another place. This is igloo. Such type of house is built in cold areas. Igloo keeps people warm. Igloo is made up of compressed snow, which is a good insulator. This snow traps heat inside the igloo. It does not allow the heat to pass through it. Temperature inside can be increased by lighting candles or having more people inside. Igloo's dome shape and its walls are well capable of blocking the freezing winds. Therefore, the temperature inside remains warmer and people feel warm in igloo. Igloo keeps us warm. House is very important for us. We feel safe inside our house. House provides us protection. House provides us shelter, so we should keep our houses and surrounding neat and clean. But how? How can we keep our houses neat and clean? We should sweep and mop the floor every day. We should throw wastes such as scraps, vegetables in the dustbin. Wastes such as bottles, polythene bags should be thrown in another dustbin. We should keep two types of dustbin. In one dustbin, we should keep such type of waste materials that can be decomposed. And in one dustbin, we should keep such type of material that cannot be decomposed. We should keep our things in proper places after using them. We should keep the dustbins covered and dispose the garbage every day. We should wash our bathrooms and toilets. We should remove cobwebs from the corners of the house once a week. We should not collect stagnant, dirty water in the surroundings of our house. It should be removed. It leads to the breeding of mosquitoes, and mosquitoes cause different diseases such as malaria and dengue. We should allow fresh air and sunlight to enter our house. By these ways, we can keep our houses neat and clean. And we will keep ourselves healthy and comfortable. So we should keep our houses neat and clean. Today, we have completed all the topics of this chapter. We have understood that why is house so important for us, different types of house, and how can we keep our houses neat and clean. Thank you for today. Have a good one. Bye.